on, folks. I'll try and get this one uploaded today. I've recorded 5 videos. And didn't bother editing or uploading a single one of them. Partly because some of them were just not that entertaining at all. Not interesting at all. And part of them because I don't have my computer set up the way I want it set up. Now, I just got a new XPS 8700 with a 7 4790 processor. And it's got 16 gigs of RAM, 4 gigabyte video card, and a 1 terabyte hard drive for right at $700. It's like $689, something like that. And that's shipping and everything. I was all right with it. It was awesome. It's got a built-in memory card reader, the whole nine. Was okay with it until I got it home and figured out that I can't put my memory card or my sound card in it. Well, I've got a high-end, high-dollar Turtle Beach sound card with the digital in and out 7.1 surround sound setup, which works beautifully with my ADA 995 Altec Lansing Dell THX surround sound speaker system. Gorgeous sound. I mean, just crystal clean, clear as a bell. You can hear every note just about. Get this XPS home, get it all set up, get all my programs in it, wiped off Windows 8, piece of garbage that it is. Got this thing all installed, updated with the 50 billion updates that come with Windows 7 now. And got several free USB 3.0 up to USB ports on it. Still a couple 2.0 ones on there too, but moving up in the world from what I had. Because what I had, well, I still have, just not using it right now, was a Optiplex 960 about to kill me Optiplex 960 quad core. It's a core 2 quad with I think it was a 3.6 core 2 quad. And this is a 3.6 quad-core i7. Got it all set up, and it's a great running machine. But that the 6.1 Dell surround sound, or 7.1, whatever it is, that's built into the motherboard, has got nothing on that Turtle Beach. I think it's a Montego, if I remember right. But nowhere near as clean sounding, nowhere near as full sounding as the Turtle Beach sound card. So I went in debt a little bit further. I've got the Optiplex 9020 on its way to me. i7, 12 gigs of RAM. Terabyte hard drive. I'm trying to think. That one's got a 1 gig video card in it. I think that's all on that one. Of course, that one doesn't have the built-in memory card reader, which is okay. I'll figure something else out that way. The Media Bay card reader for that one is like $25 off of eBay. So, no big deal. I can get that and handle it. Basically, the 9020 is the same thing as the Optiplex 960 that I had. The only difference is more memory, faster processor, and of course I'll be adding the Media Bay card reader. Now, because my wife has also gone 8 years without a computer upgrade, I'll be relinquishing my XPS 8700 to her, but she's not getting it like it is. I'll be swapping out the 4 gig video card for a 1 gig. She'll still have her hard drive that she can put in there. It'll still have the 1 terabyte hard drive in there. Still have the 12 gigs of memory. Actually, both of them. By the time I'm done, we'll have 12 gigs of memory. And I'll be able to use my Montego sound card. So, everybody will be happy. And I'll have a beefed up machine that I can finally edit on, that it won't take 5 days to edit a 20 minute video or a 10 minute video. That's been the biggest pet peeve of mine with that quad core. I mean, that quad core will do the editing all day long. Problem is, it's only got a 1 gig video card, hardly any CUDA cores on it at all. And CUDA cores help out big time when it comes to rendering and video. Don't help out a whole lot when you're editing, but when you're rendering it, it helps out quite a bit. So, basically, sticking with the type of case that we're used to, because she's got an XPS 410, I think it is, right now, which was an awesome system at the time we got it. The only thing that hers don't have that those XPS systems had back then is there's a little 2.5 by 2.5 inch LCD screen that went in the top of it. I told you like the temperatures of the cores and any error messages that might have come up on it. Also displayed on that little LCD. Hers didn't have the LCD. No big deal. She's had it in a cabinet in the side of her desk anyway, so it's not like she'd have seen it. But she was plenty happy when I told her I was giving her that machine. Now we'll both have an i7. There won't be any jealousy or envy there at all. And I won't have to hear her complain because she don't have as fast of a machine, which she wasn't really complaining anyway. But I won't have to hear any complaining either. Let's see, the puppy. Puppy is, he's still like a little piranha. Sucker's got some super sharp teeth, and he still hasn't learned not to chew on everything, so we've got to watch him. And it wouldn't be so bad, except for the fact that he actually comes up, and God forbid you be sitting there barefoot, like in a pair of shorts or some sleek pants or something like that. He likes playing with the little flappy pant legs of your sleek pants. He'll gnaw on those like it's a chew toy also. But he'll straight rip your feet apart. He don't care. That's all I ever saw. I mean, like I said, he's got those little needle teeth, and they'll just sear right through your flesh. I mean, I don't have blood dripping everywhere the whole time he's out. We've gotten to where we're crating him at night for right now, at least until he can learn not to chew on everything. And then once he gets older and we can trust him out and about, won't be as big a deal. We won't even have to worry about the crate. But we got him a full-size crate anyway. And it's an immense thing too, boy. The biggest crate that they offered, biggest crate that we could find, and bought the pad to go in it for him too. Now, one thing I like about that pad is it's the bottom of it's Kevlar. The top of it probably isn't going to last very long. I'm sure they've made it out of some durable carpeted type fabric, but I just don't see it lasting as long as the Kevlar bottom. Call it a hunch. Especially not with Sharky's machine, the pup, in there. Little piranha sucker. Finally sent me his documentation, so we got all the papers now. He's fully registered and licensed. All we gotta do now is go get him chipped. Not really sure where we're gonna go do that, but remarkably, it's not that expensive to have them microchipped. feet. Me and him are gonna go round and round. Our little dachshund and him are about the same size. Actually, he's a little bigger than the dachshund already, because the dachshund's a miniature dachshund. And him and the dachshund will play a little bit, and then when the dachshund is tired, doesn't want to play with him anymore, he'll just snap at him and walk off. Our golden lab, he'll play a little bit for a very short period of time, and then he'll snap at him and walk off. In the house and get it all set back up again. But thank you for watching. I'll talk to you soon. See ya.